Hola, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Soy Paula de Speak Spanish with Paula, and today we're going to talk about noun genders. How do you know when a noun is masculine or feminine? And at the end of the video, you'll take a quiz. So, agarra tu cuaderno y tu lápiz y toma notas, okay? Feminine nouns go with the articles la and una for singular and las and unas for plural. And masculine nouns go with the articles el and uno for singular and los and unos for plural. And remember that also the adjective get genders. Why? Because they have to describe the noun, and because of that they have to match with the gender of the noun. For example, how do you say the red car? El carro rojo. Rojo in masculine because carro es masculino. How do you say the red table? La mesa roja. Roja because mesa is feminine. Okay? So you have probably heard that nouns ending in O are masculine. El libro, el vaso, el ojo, el teléfono. And words ending in A are feminine. La mesa, la boca, la casa, la cocina, la ducha. But there are always exceptions. La moto, el sofá, la mano, el día, el idioma, and so on. So I'm going to give you some extra general rules to help you identify the noun gender. But keep in mind there are always exceptions. So the best thing you can do is to read, write, and listen as much as possible. Okay? Let's start with the masculine rules. Number one, nouns coming from Greek ending in ma, ta, and pa are most likely to be masculine. El idioma, el mapa, el planeta, el tema. The second one is for nouns ending in aje and hambre. They're most probably to be masculine. El equipaje, el paisaje, el garaje, el calambre, el enjambre, and el hambre. Which is a tricky one because we say el hambre en el mundo es un problema. But we say tengo mucha hambre. So could be feminine or masculine, depending on the context. What can I say? That's Spanish, right? That's what it is. And number three, if a noun ends in L, N, R, or S, it's probably masculine as well. El animal, el árbol, el pan, el ratón, el corazón, el error, el amor, el país, el estrés. And before you get stressed out, estresado or estresada, let's talk about feminine nouns rules. Number one, nouns ending in D are most likely to be feminine. La pared, la ciudad, la salud, la libertad. The second one, if a noun ends in IE, NTE, umbre, or ion, it's probably feminine. La serie, la carie, la gente, la corriente, la mente, la costumbre, la legumbre, la canción, la reunión, and so on. And finally, number three, if a noun ends in Z, it's probably feminine as well. La paz, la luz, la voz, la vejez. But of course, there are always exceptions. El pez, el lápiz, y el arroz. I hope you wrote down the rules because now you are going to take a quiz. I'll show you words and you gotta tell me whether it's masculine or feminine. Are you ready? Empecemos. Cine. El cine. Clima. El clima. Llave. La llave. Foto. La foto. It comes from fotografía. La foto. Diploma. El diploma. Disco. La disco. Disco comes from discoteca. La disco. Paraguas. El paraguas. Nube. La nube. Síntoma. El síntoma. Pared. La pared. Reporte. El reporte. Galería. La galería. Celebración. La celebración. Mente. La mente. Viaje. El viaje. Salud. La salud. Jardín. El jardín. And finally, suerte. La suerte. ¿Cómo te fue? ¿Tuviste suerte? Let me know in the comments down below if it was easy or a little bit complicated. Let me know. That's it for today. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to subscribe, to hit the notification bell, to give me a thumbs up, and to share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time in the next video. Ciao!